This video is sponsored by Nephrobot. Hello YouTube, and welcome to Heathen Hacks. If you're here from the previous project, glad to see you back. I assume that you've already familiarized yourself with the past 5 projects. If so, let's move on to the 6th one, called Alarm. On this project, we would use a buzzer to generate sounds with different frequencies using sinusoidal or sine waves. Let's go! Here are the things that we need for this project: a DF Arduino Uno board, prototyping shield, male-to-male jumper cables, and lastly, the buzzer. Moving on to the wiring phase, first, let's get our DF Arduino board and then mount the prototyping shield on top of it. Let's get our buzzer. As you can see here, it has a plus mark that indicates that the leg on this side is where we should connect the data pin. Connect it right here. Don't push it all the way in just yet though, so that we would see where to connect the jumper cables. Connect the green jumper cable to the leg where the plus sign is. Connect the black jumper cable to the other leg of the buzzer. Then push it all the way in. Connect the green jumper cable to DF Arduino's digital pin number 9. And then connect the black jumper cable to the ground pin like so. Now let's get our data cable and then plug in our board to the computer. Here's the sample code that DF Robot has provided. This is from the downloadable sample codes zip folder, by the way. Before we upload the code, of course, we have to make sure that the MCU is being detected and we're using the correct board. Okay, click on verify, then upload the code.
Not sure if you can hear that, but
just in case, it goes like this. And that's it for the demo. So we've just discussed what things are needed, how to connect everything, and the code demo. Now let's see how the code works. It could be quite complicated though, because it includes more maths compared to the previous projects. But just bear with me here, okay? Okay. Float synval and int toneval are the only two variables that we have declared. Here we have used another data type and it's called float. It's for floating point numbers or a number with a decimal point. Floating point numbers are often used to approximate the analog and continuous values because they have greater resolution than integers. For example, as integers, numbers 1 and 2 could only go from number 1 to 2. But by using float, it can go from 1.0000, 1.0001, 1.0002, 1.0003, 1.0004, and so on before it reaches number 2. Floating point numbers can be as large as 3.402A235E+38 and as low as negative 3.402A235E+38. They are stored as 32 bits or 4 bytes of information. We used float to store the sinusoidal values or sine wave value. Sine wave changes quite evenly in a wave shape, so we convert it to sound frequencies. Synval is the variable we used for float, which would generate the sound of different frequencies by sinusoidal value, and toneval is the variable we use to set the frequencies for the buzzer. On void setup, we have set DF Arduino's digital pin number 8 as an output using pin mode. Inside void loop, we have a for statement where x less than 180 is the condition that needs to be repeatedly compared to the initialized value to execute the statement inside it until the initialized value is not less than 180 anymore, and then repeat the loop again. Synval is the variable for the sine of x times 3.1412 divided by 180, where toneval would get its value. We need to use this formula, degree angle, which is represented by x times 3.1412 divided by 180, to convert the angle of 180 degrees to a radians value, because the unit sin or sine is radians and not degrees. In this context, x represents the degree angle, which would be incremented by the for loop. Not really sure if it's supposed to be 3.1412 or 3.1416, because in order to convert degrees to radians, we need to divide the value of pi to 180, and the value of pi is approximately 3.14159 or 3.1416 when rounded off to the nearest 4 decimal places. Sine is a trigonometric or trigonometric expression. It calculates the sine of an angle in radians, where the result will be between negative 1 and 1. X would be multiplied to the quotient of 3.1412 or 3.1416 and 180 as long as the condition of X from the for loop is less than 180. The quotient of 3.1412 and 180 is 0.01745111111111 with the sign value of 0.01745022536 0649, and the quotient of 3.1416 and 180 is 0.1745333333333 with the sign value of 0.01745244724458, which is just the same 0.01746 when rounded off to the nearest 5 decimal places, but would be quite different later on when we multiply the quotient to higher degree angle values. That's why I'm a bit confused on what to use. Should I use the pi value from the PDF or the pi value from multiple sources that agree that the value of pi when rounded off to the nearest 4 decimal places is 3.1416. Not gonna lie, I'm more inclined on using 3.1416 instead of 3.1412. Okay?
Okay!
So, the quotient, or 0.01...
You know what? I think I'm just going to refer to long numbers like this with code encode this number. Okay, carry on.
Multiplied to 0 after initialization is still equal to 0 because any number multiplied to 0 becomes 0. The product of this number and x from the initialized x value, which is 0, would then be incremented to 1. After that, the for loop would compare and check if the initialized value of x, which was just incremented to 1, is less than 180 and so on. Okay, let's just say that the condition on the for loop has been comparing the product of this number and x for 179 repetitions now. If that's the case, this number would now be multiplied by 179, and the product is this number, which has a sign value of this number. And since 179 is still less than 180, we would need to increment it again. And the product of this number and 180 is this number, 3.1416 if we use the pi value. Well, anyway, since we only need to generate a tone value, I guess no matter how different the final results are, we can still use one of them. After incrementing 179 to 180, the condition's value is not less than 180 anymore. So it would move on to the next part of the code, and since it's the only block of code inside the void loop, it would just repeat the process. This line of code right here is what we will use to convert the radiance value from synval to sound frequency. Synval is a floating variable with a decimal point, and we don't want decimal points on our frequency value. So, we need to change synval to an integer value by using the data type int. As an example, let's just say that the synval's value is this number. Multiply synval's value by 1000, then convert it to integer. After that, let's add the 2000 and the sum would be 3000. Human ears can notice sound of frequencies from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So we multiply the raw value by 1000 times. Plus 2000 to assign the value of toneval to give us a range of 2000 to 3000 Hz. Moving on to tone. Tone 8 toneval. Tone has two parameters, pin and frequency. Pin, or where the buzzer is connected, which is on DF Robot's digital pin number 8, and frequency, or Hz. We can add a duration parameter to tone if we want it to just make a sound for a specific amount of time. We can also add another function called noTone. NoTone only has one parameter, which is pin, or where the buzzer is connected. The noTone function is to stop or end the sound from a specific pin. It is usually used in conjunction with the duration parameter on tone. Now, in order to better illustrate or make things easier for us in general, I have created a cheat sheet. On this cheat sheet, we can see how synval's value changes as the x value gets incremented from 0 to 180, and the process of converting radiance value or synval to sound frequency. I know that it can be quite confusing, so for a more in-depth explanation, please refer to the PDF. Click right here if you feel ready to move on to the next project. See ya!